सेकंड क्लास। नाउ विल सॉल्व सिंपल प्रॉब्लम, वेरी सिंपल। दिस आर ऑल वेरी सिंपल, नो नीड टू कैलकुलेट, बट आई हैव सम अदर इंटेंशन, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई सॉल्व दिस सिंपल प्रॉब्लम। ओके, सिक्स मीटर्स राइज एंड दिस इज 18 मीटर्स, दिस इज 18 मीटर्स। इट हैज एन हिंज, हिंज थ्री हिंज आर्च, सो हिंज इज देयर। ओके, सो द लोड इज एक्टिंग 120 किलो न्यूटन्स एट वेयर, इट्स 12 मीटर्स। Okay, so that is the arch and that is the loading, parabolic arch, 300 parabolic arch. Solve it. So we will solve it. Solve means just shear reactions and bending moment diagram. Okay, see it. So what will happen? What are the reactions? So I call it A, B. Sorry, B. Vertical reactions are there and also horizontal reactions. VA, VB, HB, HA. HA, HE, HB is equal to, both are equal because there is no another horizontal loading is there. There is no horizontal, so compulsory HA is equal to HB because horizontal direction is only two are there. Compulsory there should be equal. So okay, you will solve it now. We will solve it. So we already know 110 is equal to VA plus VB. That's one equation. That's one equation. And see. So and see. See. So come from left side. See right side. See the left side. See there. See not left side. See the right side. From right side, just observe. This is A, B, this is C. I call it as this is C. See, at the C, moment is zero, bending moment is zero, na? At the C, bending moment is zero, na? Because it is a hinge. So, see, it is VB, VB multiply with 18, HB multiply with 6 is equal to 0. That's it, na? So, what will happen? VB into E is equal to HB equal to 6. So, 3 times. 3VB equal to HB. That's it. Another equation. Another equation. So that's it. Na? So if come from left side, now come from left side. So left side is VA into 18. Same. BMC is equal to 0. Not a BMC. Bending moment at C is equal to 0. VA multiply with 18. Okay. VA multiply with 18 minus HA multiply with 6, HA multiply with 6, and also 120 multiply with, what is that value? What is that value? 6 meters, na? 6 meters, 120 multiply with 6 equal to 0. That's another equation, same, from left side, from right side, bending moment is 0. So what will happen? What will happen? See, HA is equal to HB. You already know HA is equal to HP. So 18 VA minus C. HA means 3VB. 3VB na? 3VB into 6, 720 equal to 0. That's it. 18 VA, 18 VB is equal to 720. So VA minus VB is equal to the 720 by 8 is a 4. It's a 4. Okay, so that's it. Not so 40. Okay, 40. So VA plus VB is 120. VA minus VB is 40. Solve it. Solve it. Just add those. Add those two. 2VA is equal to 160. VA is 80. VA is 80. VB is 40. That's it. That's it. This is 80. That is 40. 80, 40. Understood? That's the equation. That's the scenario. 80, 40. Okay. So that's not a problem. Next, see what is HB? HB is what? HB is what? HB is 3HB. What does that mean? 40 is 120. So HB is 120. HA is also 120. That's it, na? So we got the reactions. Four reactions. We got it. We got the four reactions. That's it. You can use simple. Otherwise, no need to this much of distance. You can use some methods. Okay, no problem. So that's not my topic. Just we got the reactions. Now we want to find out the bending moments. Okay, so bending moments. So see the bending moments. See, bending moment at C is 0. You already know it. Bending moment at C is equal to 0. Otherwise, see, 40 multiply with 18 is equal to the 120 multiply with 6. 120 multiply with 6. You know it. Okay, that's it. See, you see it is bending moment at C is 0. Bending moment at C is equal to 0. So bending moment at some other location, maybe some other location, take it as a sum. Okay, some, okay, no problem. Some other location may be, some other location may be taken. Why don't you take that side? So I will take from this side. So this side, exactly what is the bending moment? Bending moment at that location of T, I call it as a T. What is the bending moment at those location? So bending moment at those location is Y, something Y, I call it as. So what is that bending moment at D? No need. We will discuss later. Bending moment at D is what? VA multiply with 12. Okay? VA multiply with 12 minus HA multiply with Y. Vertical distance, na? Vertical distance. So what is Y? So what is Y? We don't know Y. So how can we find out the Y? How can we find out the Y? So we already know the parabolic theorem. Y is 4h by L square x minus L minus x. That's it. So what is H? H is 6. Rise. H is a rise. Central rise. Okay. Crown. Crown point height. So H is rise. Okay. So 4 into 6 divided by L is total length. Total length is 36. X is, this is X. This is X. 12 meters. Okay. 12 meters. 36 minus 12. What is that value? 36 minus 12. 24. So 5.33 meters. Okay, that's it. This height is 5.33 meters. So, okay, so sir, you already said something like x square by y is constant. How can we use that equation? This is also you can use. So parabola, if parabola is there, parabola is there, x square by y is also, you can use it. So how can you use? See, it is x square by y is taken when the C, crown point as origin. See, x square by y taken as constant, some a is crown as a origin. So how it is? See, you can use both formulas. Whenever, which one is free, which one is you think, that's it, na? This is a crown as a origin. Okay, that's it. rho is the origin. X square by y is means this curve is x square by y is constant when this is the reference curve. So that means what? That means what? See, it is. This is the height. This is the curve. And this is a reference line. This is a reference line. So increase. See, it is this increase, this increase, this increase. So these are the x's. Then that means these are the y's. These are the now y's. And these are the x. These are the x. So that means what? So if you understood, otherwise I will give this. That's it. This is the equation. See, this is the crown point. Okay. So these are the incremental from this location. Okay. So see, it is x square by y is constant. See x square. So if you take an x is a, if you take an x is a 18 meters, what is y? What is y? Y is 6. Are understood? What is this height? What is this height? This height is 6 na? 6. So x square by y is constant. That means 6. It is what is 18? 18 square by 6 is a constant. Throughout the span, C is taken as origin. It's a constant. So what you required? Sir, I required this length, sir. I required this length. But if you find out this length, na? If you find out this length, if you find out this length, you can easily find out this length, na? That's it. So what is that length? What is the that length? What is that length? So what is the distance from this origin? What is the distance from origin? So distance from origin is what? This is 12 means this is 6, na? That is 6. So take it. It is a 6. What is y? That's it. See, it is nothing more than 18 square by 6 is constant. 6 square by that y. What is that? That's it. That's just a Euclid. That's the value is constant throughout. Same if you want something. If you want something from distance of 10. Take it as directly 10. 10 square by that y. What is that y? Something y dash. Like this. So you can easily find out. X square by y is constant throughout the span. It is a parabolic property. So what is y? What is y? Take it as. So 6 multiply with 6 square 36. Answer divided by 18 square. 0.067. Are understood? 0.67. So that's it. If it is 0.67, what is the remaining value? What is the remaining value? 6 minus 0.67, it is a 5.33. Are understood? That's a 5.33. So you can find by using this formula, or you can use this formula, whichever you feel comfort or whichever you feel easy, do it. It's okay. That's the use of those two curves which are related to parabolic curve. Okay, those are the parabolic equations, parabolic curve properties. Okay, no need. So that's it. If you see, what is exactly the bending moment at D? Now it is a bending moment at D. I want bending moment at D. So bending moment at D is what? Bending moment at D is what? See, reaction is 80. Horizontal reaction is what? 120. So 80 multiplied with what is distance of 12? 12 meters. Huh? Distance of 12 minus 120 multiplied with 5.33. That's it, na? 5.33. That's it. So what is that bending moment? See, it is 80 multiplied with 12. Answer minus 120 multiplied with 5.33. So this is 320. This again 120 minus 5.3. 690. Answer minus. It's a 320.4. kilo newton meter. Okay, that's it. So, but I want to explain something. Okay, see, first, just remove everything. Just remove everything. This is a 40. This is a 120. Not a 120. This is 80. Just take a linear. So where is the curve? This is a 120, which is distance of 12, na? 12. So span length is 36. That's it, na? Take a just linear. Just a convenience. Just take a convenience. What is the Bennington diagram? What is the Bennington diagram? You know Bennington diagram, very easy. What is that? PAB by L. Understood? PAB by L. So what is that value? 120. A is 12. B is 24. Answer divided by 36. 960. 960, na? Just take it as. This is a 960. Are you just observe it? It is a 80 into 12 is a 960. Are you understood? 80 into 12 is a 960. So when the arch is used, when we use arch, its bending moments are decreasing by horizontal component is rising. Are you understood? This is a horizontal component is rising, na? This is a horizontal component is rising. Everything, this is a vertical component. Something is lessing. Something is reducing the total amount. Something is reducing the total amount. Are you understood? And same thing, if you observe it. So bending moment at C is crown point is what? Its crown point is what? Zero. So crown point is zero. Are you understood? So zero. How it we get? 40 into 18 minus of 120 into 6. This is the value, na? This is the value. So 18 into 40, 720. This is also 720. So, okay, are understood? So, this is the negative component. So, this is the negative component, na? So, this is a positive, not a positive. This is a linear component. If you are only using the linear value, so straight beam, you will get, these are the components. This is a 920. This is a 920. If you are using from left side, at C is, you will get 40 into 80, 720. 720 you will get at the center. Okay, no problem. So, see, how I represent bending moment diagram. So, bending moment diagram represents like, see it is. Now I see, you see. One minute. I represent something different. I want to explain something, that's why I try to draw. Okay? Try to draw. Okay? That's it. See, that's this way. That's the way I draw. Okay? See, this is the value of exactly center. Taken, this is 18 meters. This is a 12 meters. This is 6. This is also 18. Sir, why it is right? Why it is right? See, so this is, see, taken as a theoretical arch. Theoretical arch, not our arch, theoretical arch, taken as. Why it is, I will explain it. Okay. See, exactly bending moment is. So, bending moment is, see, this is a bending moment only. This is a nullify. This is a nullify thing. How I will represent, I will explain it. Okay, this is another thing. See, see exactly the triangle represents when there is no horizontal forces. That exactly triangle represents when there is no horizontal reactions are there. If horizontal reactions are developed, that will reduce the vertical component value. Na? That will reduce the vertical component value. Vertical component producing the bending moment is reducing. Na? So if you see at every location, see somewhere it, where it is at this location. This is the location you see. Just it is. It is the location you see. This is the value. So what is the exact value? So this is a 960. So something is reducing. 120 minus 5.53 is reducing. Understood? We will get 340. So this is a value of 320.4. 325. So what is this value? Sir, what is that yellow value? Yellow color value is this component. 120 into 5.3. So this is horizontal component. 120 into 5.3. 120 into some say 4.3 something. So this one thing is positive, one thing is negative. Remaining will value, you will get. Exactly see the center. Exactly see that center. Our linear value, see our, if you take in our exact, our straight line, what is that exact center? It's the value of 720. 40 into 18 or 80 into something 18. So it's 40 into 18. So, okay. So 18 into 80 minus 120 into 6. From this side or this side, anything. That value is 720. Where is this 720? This is 720. Understood? So exactly by horizontal component, 720 will rise. So neglect resultant value is 0. You can observe it now. So the white component, white diagram represents the when it is a linear. Okay. What is the yellow component represents? It is a horizontal component. 1 minus 1. So one thing, 1 minus another one will get resultant value. Well, resultant value. Okay. So if you see it is, the portion it will, left side portion will give positive component. Positive component. Everything you will get positive. Positive means sagging moment you will get. But if you come left side, if you see our white diagram represents below the yellow component. That means what? Horizontal component is rising. Horizontal component is everywhere is higher. Sir, if you otherwise check it. Otherwise check the any other, otherwise if you check any another, so we'll check directly where it is. Same 12, I will take it's a 12. So directly it will come 5.33, no problem at all. It's 5.33, no? It's again 5.33. So if you check where it is, this is the location. Okay, this is the location, you will check. Otherwise this is the location, 18 plus 6, 24, or otherwise this is 12 meters. Check what is the bending moment at here, check it is. So 40 into 12 minus 120 into 120 multiply with 5.33. What you will get? 40 into 12 answer minus 120 minus 5.5 minus 159. Minus 159.6. Minus component. That is a minus component. So that's it. So if you see it is exactly this value. This is where from this 12 meters. You will get 159.6 minus. This is a minus portion. Okay. This is a minus portion. So negative. That is a horizontal component. This is a sagging. This is a hogging moments. These are the sagging moments. You will get. Sir, how you drawn that curve? What is that curve? Exactly. You can represent the bending moment diagram directly like this. You don't want to waste your time by finding out the exact, those are the different locations. So you can directly draw a curve. And directly take in this bending moment diagram of when the beam is like linear beam. You can directly represent bending moment diagram like this. You can't find out every location directly represent. Sir, my intention is, what is the that exactly what is that theoretical arch? How can you draw? What is that theoretical arch? The theoretical arch is like, see it is. The theoretical arch is which has a no bending moment diagram. Which has no bending moment. Yesterday I shown that if uniformly distributed load is acting throughout the span, there is no bending moment at all. There is no bending moment at all. But if you see some, now we get some different loading. We get some different loading. So this is a theoretical arch which has a no bending moment. Which has no bending moment. That is a represents of zero. Represents of zero. Okay, represents of zero. So see, every bending moment, every location, bending moment is directly, if you see, bending moment is directly proportional with the these height, na? These height, every direction, this is a bending moment. Bending moment is proportional to these heights, na? That means that is the height only. That is a height. That is a bending moment. But if you take in some value means what? That is a h value. That is value of h, horizontal component of that height. Sir, what is that height? That height is means by bending moment, na? What is? So if you cleanly observe that every component is, that bending moment is some h into something, h into something. So this h 120 into 5.3, na? So if you draw 120 outside, it will get something 120 multiplied with 120 multiplied. So every bending moment is like this. That is a, what is that? I will explain what is that. So now I conclude that, not a conclude. Now I will explain Eddy's theorem. Eddy's theorem in the textbook. What is that Eddy's theorem? Okay. What is that Eddy's theorem? Okay. Now I will write Eddy's theorem. It states that the bending moment at any section of an arch is proportional to the vertical component, not a vertical component, it's a vertical intercept or difference in elevation between the linear arch, funicular or theoretical arch and center line of the actual arch having the same span and horizontal thrust for a given system of load. That is the Eddy's theorem. What does that mean? Eddy's theorem means what? if you take any arch, any type of arch. So if you take any type of arch, that is the actual arch. The bending moment at any section is proportional to the vertical component, difference in elevation of the vertical component. See, vertical intercept between the linear arch and the center line of the actual arch. Sir, what is a linear arch? What is a linear arch? That is a question. Or funicular structure. What is a funicular? You will get that part even to the later. So many times you can hear advice. Okay. So what is a linear arch and what is the center actual arch? This is the actual arch. Okay. No need. no need a problem. This is the actual hours. Okay, there is the actual hours. So what is the funicular structure? Funicular structure is, if something is loading applied on this part, if loading is applied on this part, so if you get exactly the opposite direction, if you get exactly the opposite direction, see, no need. Funicular structure means just to taken this. If you applied a vertical force, don't take it as a beam, it is just a wire. So if you just take it, that wire is no need of beam, just take it. This is a wire, just hold it. You put one load, what will come? It will take shape of like this, now. Otherwise, everyone is sitting in some there. Take your charging cable, just hold it both sides and put some force. What will shape will get? It will get like this now. Otherwise, if you take a just wire, put two loads. What will get? Which shape will get? This shape will get now. Just your charging wire, yeah. Take a cable. That is called a cable, charging cable. Just put one inside, exactly center, one force. How will it come? It will come like this. Now. So if you observe it, if there is no flexural rigidity, if there is no flexural rigidity in the member, when the load is applied, that deformed shape exactly represents the bending moment diagram of a beam. So these are all exactly bending moment diagrams, sir. These are all exactly bending moment diagrams when that particular load is acting. Understood? If there is no flexural rigidity in the beam, so beam means just it's a wire. There is no flexural rigidity. It can't take a bending moments. That's why it deforms. So if you apply a loading, it will give directly the deform. If you give some shape, if you see that shape, it exactly represents the bending moment diagram. Anyone? So next time some faculty gives certain loading and draw bending moment diagram, you can't find out what is the shape of bending moment diagram. No need. Just take some simple wire and put that loading. You can easily identify what is the shape of bending moment diagram. You can easily get. So if you see something, uniformly distributed load is applied, what is the shape we'll get? Uniformly distributed load. So compulsory shape will come like this. Are understood? That is now uniformly distributed load. Some just put a wire at two points in your hand. Take one end and second end. So apply some uniformly distributed load. Put your something calculator or something. So some wide loading. What shape will get? Shape will get like this. So these are called funicular shape. Funicular shape. Okay, are understood? So that's it. That's the reason. If you see, cables has no flexural rigidity. If you say this is a cable, and you put loading, it will go to some force. Okay. Otherwise, I represent like this. If you applied a load at some place, it will go like this shape, and the force is acting like this. How they have taken force? How the force is transformed throughout the span? Only by axial force. It takes some axial force. There is no bending moment. Those are the funicular shapes. Those are the discussed in cables next unit, but those are not included in our syllabus. If you take any cables chapter, there is no bending moment at all because there is no flexural rigidity. If you apply certain loading, it will give some deformation, but throughout the span will take that load is taken by only axial force, not by bending moment. Directly it takes a bending moment like, not a bending moment, take an axial force like this. You can solve. So you can solve, this is a P, how much it is, you can solve it, and it's only designed for axial forces. Those are the funicular shapes. Okay. So if you apply it, same thing. Now I am interested, if you apply it, certain load here, certain load here, certain load here, certain load here, certain load here. What will happen? Will come. It will. So if you apply the infinite loadings, what will get? Infinite loading, and otherwise throughout the span, every point load, what will get? It will get exactly the parabolic shape. It will get exactly parabolic shape. If you just see, if you just apply one loading, another loading, what will get? It will go like this. Otherwise, if you apply another loading, it will go. It will go like this. Otherwise, inko apply loading, it will go. It will go. If you apply loading, it will go. So if you apply it throughout the span, what will get? You will get a curve, parabolic curve. So if you take in, that is an example, if you applied so many point loads or infinite point loads, it will give exactly parabolic shape. That is a theoretical parabolic. That is a theoretical arch. What is that means? Theoretical arch doesn't take any bending moment. We already solve it. Yesterday we already solve it. We already solved when a uniformly distributed load is acting, there is no bending moment at all. The same represents when infinite point loads are acting, infinite point loads are acting, it will give exactly the parabolic shape. That means throughout the span. Okay? So that is the theoretical arch which has no bending moment at all. There is no bending moment at all. That is the line represents this. This is the line represents this yellow curve. That is the line represents yellow curve. That is the theoretical arch which has, there is no bending moment at all. If see, what is he said, that if it is a bending moment is applied, so if the certain arch is there which has some forces applied, if you just taken as theoretical arch, what is the theoretical arch? Just applied a reverse loading. Just reverse loading. What will get? Will get like this. Just shape. Theoretical arch shape. Okay, theoretical arch for that point loading. For that point load. So for that point load, it will get like something like, that's it. So just apply a point load for that point load, it will get actual arch. So sorry. This is not a theoretical arch. This is a actual arch. That is actual arch. Okay, representation. This is a theoretical arch. Theoretical arch means when point load is applied on a certain cable. Certain cable, when point load is applied, what shape will get? There is a funicular shape. So in that shape, there is no bending moment at all. That's it. So there's, in this shape there is no bending moment at all. I said in this same, there is no bending moment at all. So if you applied a point load, it will give like this shape. The vertical intercept between this total theoretical arch. This is a theoretical arch. That's the theoretical arch. And this is the actual arch. This is the actual arch. So what is that arch? Vertical intercept is this much. Okay. So the vertical intercept between the theoretical arch and the actual arch, this value. So the bending moment at any section is proportional to the y theoretical arch minus y actual. That's the exactly, if you see the bending moment diagram, how you will get? That is the exact shape you will get. Exact, this value 320 or so, this value 159. How you will get? You will get by directly doing the formulas. You will get it. But you can directly represent by this. How can you, sir? Just draw a theoretical arch. And this is an actual arch. The bending moment is directly proportional to the vertical intercept of the theoretical arch minus actual arch. That's it. So you will get it. Otherwise, if something load is also there, in where something like this is there. How can you draw Venn Diagram? You can easily draw. How can you draw? So just see, imagine if another node is also there, how the theoretical arch will happen? How the theoretical arch shape will get? The theoretical arch shape will get like, you will easily imagine. That's it. That's it. See, if that is the loading and this loading, you will get. Otherwise, that's it. So that is, this will go like this and this will go like this. So you can directly draw actual arch and theoretical arch, and you directly mention this is cancel, this is a positive, 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 positive. That is the bending moment. Directly write, represent it. Can you represent it? So easily represent it. So that is the theoretical arch. Theoretical arch means that is, there is no bending moment at all. When it gets a funicular shape, when it reaches its funicular shape, it has no bending moment at all. So see the lens, see the cables. If see the cable, just take your charging cable, everyone has it. Just put those two sides, just put it down and apply any point loading, it will get shape. That is a bending moment shape, exactly. So how will get it? There is no flexural rigidity, that's why it gives shape. There is no flexural rigidity at all, it can't take a bending moments. So it will deform, it will deform, it will deform. They transfer the forces throughout the span by only axial forces. That is the concept of cables. Understood? So now you can see that this is the 300 arches. We know it is a theoretical arch. When it has a theoretical arch, there is no bending moments at all. So when you draw a theoretical arch and an actual arch, the vertical intercept between those two will give directly proportional to the bending moment at all. Directly give the bending moment at all. Okay? Understood? That's the history. That's the it. And also we have some proof also there. Very simple, but no need at all. You can learn it by next. Okay? By next you will learn it the proof at all. Okay? That is the Eddy's theorem. So later on we will draw a bending moments like this only. Like this only. I can't draw. Okay, I won't run so exactly point load, point particular load. No, I will run directly the bending moments diagrams like this. Okay, but you can easily draw. Very simple, huh? Very, very simple. Very simple. You don't need to remember at all what is the theoretical shape. Just take a charging cable and you can see it is. So that is the exactly way to represent the bending moments of the arches. Bending moments of the arches. See, this is an exactly, is the total value give. Total value is, when there is no arch, it is a straight. But if you apply an arch, something is reducing with respect to the horizontal component. So that's the H, horizontal component reducing. So finally, very small portion is there. What is the small portion? That small portion of bending moment is directly proportional to the vertical intercept between the theoretical arch and actual arch. So what is, how we will get theoretical arch? Theoretical arch shape. So theoretical arch shape will get when the beam reaches to its funicular shape. What is that funicular shape? It doesn't have any flexural rigidity. So it will give the shape when the load is applied on that particular point or throughout the span something. Okay? So, are you understood? So, that's the today topic. I feel that I will do one more problem, but I wasted so much time for explaining what is the funicular shape. Funicular shape. Okay. It's a waste of time to draw so many diagrams. But I think you got some idea. I had this idea. So, now you can easily solve the problems in cables. Otherwise, just see the cables chapter. It didn't. Now in our curriculum there is no cables chapter, okay, but maybe you can own by your own, you can solve the cables problems. Okay, it only takes axial forces, not any bending moment, because there is no flexural rigidity. Okay, that is the Eddy's theorem. That is the Eddy's theorem. He said that it is said that something like this. Okay, so tomorrow we will solve, next class we will solve more problems on arches. Different arch segments in 3D, in three hinges arches there is no problem at all, because You can easily solve those three and four unknowns. Because we have an extra hinged ground point, you can easily solve every problem. So we will solve one problem, one problem, one problem. We will solve one problem regarding the parabola, another problem, okay, another problem different, and we will solve one problem regarding this circular segment. We will solve one problem with the segmental arch. Now it's closed because remaining problems you can easily solve by different loading. You can solve any problem. If something loading is there like this, you can solve, no? You can solve, no problem at all. By using the some small is four equations, you can solve it. Fx equals 0, Fy equals 0, M equals 0, and Mc also is 0. Four unknowns, four equations, you can solve by any loading. But no problem. I will solve three different problems regarding three different arch sections. Okay. Next, we will go to the two dimensions, two hinged arches. Okay. That's it. It's the